Galen used to walk the docks with his father, letting loose and wet shoestrings slap and dance for the chance that he would learn patience from his father while fishing in the bayou. Sometimes he would wait, with his eyes closed, his arms spread, listening to the boats bump against waterlogged wood. It was Mother that made sure food was always available, working two jobs, biting fingernails to bleeding skin. Still, she had enough time to wrap brown paper bags around sandwiches, rations for her men on the docks. When the news of the storm reached the family, they boarded windows and wrapped prized possessions like packaged lollipops, but they didn't stop. They didn't leave. They were dying to live. Still, Father took his boat out, collecting crustaceans like a miner chiseling coal caverns until he noticed strange wave patterns coasting in. The bowline knot hinged the boat to the dock like eyeglasses repaired with masking tape. Earlier, he thought he was going to walk home, but now all he could hear was the sound of raindrops clapping and wind manipulating road signs as the last bus was evacuated and the levee crumbled. At home, Waylon awakes to his mother's touch, gripping him in a sloshing panic of damp brown paper bags. She whisks him up into the musk of the attic, but Waylon can't sleep, and his mother sobs, but they didn't stop. They didn't leave. They were dying to live, and Waylon is peeling open damp brown paper bags, knowing that this time he can't be a picky eater. After 3 days, Waylon can hear the sounds of bodies bump against waterlogged wood. But Waylon wasn't scared. He just closed his eyes, spread his arms, and pretended that he was at the docks, waiting for his father's boat to coast home. While the world outside is drowning, Waylon will always stay afloat by letting shoestrings play. The same way that rape victims use imagination to create dissonance, Waylon will never be scared. He learned patience from his father while fishing in the bayou.